The family living in this house on Sanford Street in Covington says they're not alone. The former owner is usually there. Unusual, though, is the fact that he died almost a century ago. Janine Vanderveer, her husband Stephen McMurtry, and their two sons have lived here for 10 years. And ever since the first night in the house, there have been incidents which gave them no choice but to believe the house was haunted. Janine remembers that first night. She and Stephen had cleared the back bedroom out for the children and their housekeeper, June. In the middle of the night, Janine heard screams and then hysterical crying. It was June.
I tried to get her calmed down. Finally, I did, and her story was that as she was laying on her bed, and she was asleep at the time, she was awakened, and maybe it was the sounds that awakened her, but a man on horseback came riding through her room and pulled up close by her bed, got off the horse, sat down for a moment, got back on the horse, and went tearing out.
9 years passed before Janine got an explanation. Through research, she learned the house was owned by Henry Bruce, a Southern Confederate in Union Territory. His wealth enabled him to help imprison Confederates. Eventually, he was found out and fled his home moments before he would have been captured. This traumatic moment, Janine believes, is what June saw. Stranger still is the fact that years later, Bruce's granddaughter, celebrated primitive artist Mary Bruce Sharon, painted her grandfather's daring escape. The figure was riding a gray-white horse, just like the housekeeper described. Behind this door is the room in which June saw the man on the horse. Shortly after the incident, the family turned the room into an apartment, hoping their problems would go away. But they didn't. In fact, the family says they still exist today. Tonight at 11, we'll go inside the room. Toria Tolley, Action 5 News.